أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين بارئ الخلائق أجمعين باعث الأنبياء والمرسلين ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين حبيب إله العالمين أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين لا سيما بقية الله في الأرضين واللعن الدائم على أعدائهم أجمعين أما بعد فقد قال الله عز وجل في كتابه الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم من كان يريد العزة فلله العزة جميعا إليه يصعد الكلم الطيب والعمل الصالح يرفعه آمنا بالله صدق الله العلي العظيم صلوات We had a tawfiq last night to begin a discussion on the idea of self-esteem. And we talked about how important self-esteem is, how important it is to have a positive understanding of ourselves, a self-image of worth that we give to ourselves. And we saw how this enables a person to aim high and achieve high goals in life, enables a person to have a strong emotional, mental well-being, enables a person to have strong relationships. And we said, and we discussed the hadith that talk about how self-esteem also helps a person to avoid sins, helps a person to detach from this world. And so how important it is for all of us, every single one of us, to build the strong identity, the strong sense of worth for ourselves. And we saw last night that the source of this self-worth, the source of this positive image that we have of ourselves, cannot be from the work that we do, the job that we have, the career that we have. Neither can it be from the possessions that we own, the material gains that we have, the watch that we wear, or the purse that we wear, the car that we drive. These things does not give us a sense of worth. And so we want to see tonight, what is it? What is the source that we can use to earn this self-worth? To understand this, we need to go back and ask this question. Why is it that this material possession cannot give us worth? To understand this, we need to realize that feelings, emotions, ideas that we have can be of two kinds. Our emotions, at times, they are based on something that is not real. We go through emotions in our lives. At times, these emotions don't have a reality behind it. It is not based on something that is true. Rather, it's based on something that we have imagined, an idea that we have in our head. And this idea, this imagination, which has no basis, has no reality, can lead us to have a feeling, an emotion. And we know that this has no value. And you find that it's possible that we come up with an imaginary idea and use that to create an image of ourselves. And this is what I talk about. When we use material possessions, a purse or a car or a house, to build a sense of worth for ourselves that has no value. It's an imaginary thing that you have used to create a sense and a feeling in yourself. There's no whole value. Unfortunately, in modern world, this is highly promoted. The world that we live in today, modernity, has a lot of emphasis on feelings and emotions. Even when they are baseless, they don't have to have any reality behind it. Take self-acceptance, for example. Accept me for who I am. Irrespective of my behavior, how good I behave, irrespective of the fact that I might not be a very morally good person, I want you to accept me for who I am. I build in myself an image of self-worth. I sit down and convince myself, looking in the mirror, repeating to myself, I'm a good person, I'm an amazing person, I'm an amazing person. Creating in myself a sense that I am a good person, a sense of positive self-esteem, asking you to accept me for who I am. But all this is baseless. It has no value. It holds no value. And so what we're really after, what we really want, is a self-esteem that goes back to reality. That goes back to something that is true, that is stable, that has value, that is real. So that we don't have emotions and feelings that has no value and no worth. And so what is this self-esteem, this feeling, this positive feeling about ourselves? That we need to have this positive feeling about ourselves, this image of ourselves that is worthy and valuable, but it is based on reality. How do we build this? Look at what the Quran says. مَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ الْعِزَّةِ Whoever wants this izzah, whoever is seeking this self-esteem, فَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ جَمِيعًا Allah has izzah. Izzah, worth, belongs to Allah. Power belongs to Allah. True value, true worth, belongs to Allah. That which is stable, that which is unshaken, that which is real, that which owns everything is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the verse doesn't end here. إِلَيْهِ يَسْعَدُ الْكَلِمُ الطَّيِّبُ Kalimut tayyib, the pure word, it's not an empty word, it's a meaning. It's a pure meaning, a pure understanding. Or in other words, it's faith. That understanding of who Allah is. And when we have this true understanding of who Allah is, that true faith, yas'adu, it rises, it gains proximity to Allah, it acquires izzah. That faith leads us to acquire true izzah that Allah has. And still it doesn't end here. وَالْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحُ يَرْفَعُهُ Good actions, true, pure good actions, is that which rises and raises the true faith. In other words, this verse is telling us that the reality out there is this, that worth belongs to Allah. And if we were to build faith in Allah through good actions, then we too can acquire izzah. And this is why elsewhere in the Holy Quran we are told, وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ Allah possesses izzah and worth. وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ That this izzah belongs to the Prophet and the believers. And so self-worth and this positive image of ourselves goes back to truth, which is that in reality I believe that worth belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's try and open this up a little bit more. You see, we need to understand that the reality is this, that we don't own anything. That everything belongs to Allah. Every material possession that we have, those nice shoes, that smartphone, that fame and the praise that people might give, that knowledge that I have and the skill and the beautiful career and the beautiful house, my actions, myself, everything belongs to Allah. When I understand this, but I realize that I'm nothing, but this nothingness doesn't end here, because that'll be depression then. If I don't have anything, if I'm nothing, I'm unworthy, then that's mental health issues. No. I am nothing. I don't own anything. I am empty. But I rely on Allah. I depend on Allah. I am connected to Allah through this faith. That is what gives true worth. That whilst I am nothing and I understand the reality of the matter is that I am nothing, but I'm also connected to absolute power. I'm connected to absolute worth and value. Suddenly I am everything. I have everything. Nothing moves me. Nothing shakes me. That is true worth. That is unshaken value that you can give and you can have. If you can picture it like this, we have to understand that I am an empty cup. But this empty cup is brought forward to the one who has everything. Ya ayyuhal aziz, I have come to you with an empty cup. You fill it. The more I understand that I'm an empty cup, the more Allah fills it. Our problem is we come with a full cup. I have this and I have that, my job and my belongings. My cup is full. Then obviously we feel dhaleel inside. We don't have anything really. But the moment we put everything aside and realize that I don't own anything, I am just an empty cup. And then you extend your hand to Allah and says, oh Allah, I am empty. Allah fills it. This is the true self-esteem that we have been taught in the Quran and from the Ahlul Bayt. And you find that the prophets and the Ahlul Bayt and the companions and the true believers are like this. At the beginning, the people will come to the Prophet and say, we will fill your hands with everything that you want in this world. Everything. He would say, you place the sun on my right hand and the moon on my left hand. Don't need it. See that power? Look at the story of Musa, alayhi salam. He enters the court of Fir'aun, dressed like a simple person, like a shepherd. Holding a stick in his hand, he enters the throne of Fir'aun. Just imagine. Sit on this minbar in front of my humble brothers and sisters. Sometimes you feel your heart is beating too fast. Imagine entering the palace of Fir'aun, the greatest of all kings. Guards surrounding him, gold and silver, power and might. I'm entering with my stick. My simple clothes, tells Fir'aun, I am a messenger of Allah. You liberate right now Bani Israel, unshaken. You think this is Musa? Let me tell you about the magicians. You know the story. Fir'aun calls the best of magicians to come in front of Musa. And these magicians, they turn to Fir'aun. What are we getting from this? And Fir'aun promises them everything. You will get everything from me. Defeat Musa. In front of a huge crowd looking at this, they tell Musa, you go first, we go first. Musa says, after you. So they performed the best of magic that they could perform. As soon as Musa performs his miracle, they realize. They know and realize that what we have is just magic. Over here, I just realized that there is a Rabb to whom everything belongs, and they submit. Pharaoh turns to them, so what are you doing? Without my permission? I will torture you. I will do this and that to you. قَالُوا إِنَّا إِلَىٰ رَبِّنَا لَمُنْقَلِبُونَ. So you can't do anything to us. We're going back to our Lord anyways. Look at that strength in those magicians. And it didn't take too long. The space of a few minutes. Just this realization that we are nothing. The greatest of magicians, we are nothing. Everything belongs to Allah. And suddenly they acquire this worth that is so amazing that they are unshaken in front of this Pharaoh. If you look at Amir al-Mu'mineen, on the battlefield, the greatest of war warriors, nothing shakes him. The same Amir al-Mu'mineen you would look at him at home with his dry barley naan, you would wonder, where is this coming from? Maybe you would hear his dua kumail when he would say, Ilahi, who else do I have other than you? مَنْ لِي غَيْرُكَ. They would find Amir al-Mu'mineen in a state like a beggar. Let me come to this point. We're approaching the nights of Qadr. There's a dua that we recite in the nights of Qadr that you, inshallah, have heard of, and we've all recited this dua, the dua Abu Hamza Thamali. In fact, this dua we have in hadith that Imam al-Sajjad will recite this dua every night of the month of Ramadan. It's not specific to the night of Qadr. Inshallah, we too can try and recite this dua, parts of this dua. Amongst the things and the beautiful themes of this dua is exactly this. It teaches us and makes us realize this true reality that we are nothing, that we are an empty cup. And that if we present ourselves like this in front of Allah, then Allah will fill our cup. Oh Allah, what is my worth? What is my value? I am this small servant that you have raised. I am this poor person that you have given everything. I am this ill person that you have given health. I am nothing. Oh Allah, grant me not based on my actions. My actions are worth nothing. Don't give me based on what I have. No, base me on what I have, how much hope I have in you because of who you are. In this dua we learn to understand and to realize that we cannot rely on ourselves. We cannot rely on what we have. Our identity and our worth does not go back to who we are and our career and what we possess and the fame and the praise that people give us. All of that you put aside and you realize your nothingness and your dependency on Allah, and you turn to Allah and say, I am nothing, you fill my cup. Then you realize how much power that gives to us, how much sense of worth that gives to us. And this is something we find in riwayat so beautiful. Amir al-Mu'min says, وَعَلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا عِزَّ لِمَنْ لَا يَتَذَلَّلُ لِلَّهِ. There is no izzah for the one who doesn't have this dhillat in front of Allah, the one who doesn't humble himself in front of Allah. In a hadith of Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْعَزِيزِ. I am your Lord, the Aziz, the one who has izzah, the one who has power. فَمَنْ أَرَادَ عِزَّ الدَّارَيْنِ. Whoever wants izzah in this world and the hereafter, فَلْيُتِعِ الْعَزِيزِ. And obey the Aziz. In other words, through obedience of Allah through ensuring that we count ourselves as nothing but servants who don't own anything, and we take our value from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our obedience, we gain this izzatun nafs, we gain this self-esteem, we gain this power, this unshaken ability, this height that we can achieve. This relationship that we want to be built on such beauty and greatness, this emotional well-being, this ability to confront any peer pressure, outside influence, it all goes back to our self-worth, understanding who really we are. That Allah says that there is nothing more valuable, even more valuable than the Kaaba, than the mu'min, the believer. You've heard this hadith. And then when this happens, nothing can shake. We don't even then need to seek praise from others or value from others. One of the biggest issues that we face today is a sense of wanting to gain worth from others, to be judged positively by others. Social media is centered around this, how many likes I get. I build an image of myself based on how many people will comment, how many people will say something positive, will like me, send me flowers and hearts. But when we connect like this to Allah and realize where our true sense of worth is from, it all becomes meaningless. And I go back to everything we mentioned yesterday. If you remember the hadith that says that not a single person takabbara wa tajabbara except that he found in his nafs dhilla, right? That arrogance only stems from the sense of dhilla we find inside us. I didn't find my true worth. I lived on an emotion, a feeling that was not based on reality. I built this feeling through self-acceptance, through other means that I have learned through coaching and self-development books that teach me that I have to sit down and repeat myself that I'm an amazing person. When I build these emotions like this, then obviously then I found dhillat in my heart because it's fake. It's based on imagination. There's no reality behind it. There's no stability to it. And then I need to find it and seek it from elsewhere. Material things, people's opinions. But you find the true mu'min is not like this. Once a companion comes to Imam Sadiq and the Imam tells him that imagine you had walnut in your hand and people were to say that this is a pearl, would that make a difference to you? He says, no. I know I've got walnut in my hand. So what if you had jewelry in your hand? What if you had a pearl in your hand and people all came and said this is a walnut? He says, it won't make a difference to me. It won't make a difference to me. I know my worth. I know who I am. I know who I'm connected to. I know where true izzah lies. And the moment I realize that I am an empty cup and I extend my hand at the right place and nowhere else do I extend my hand, that's when I gain true self-worth. And so you also connect the other hadith that talk about how it's so important a person who has izzatun nafs never extends his hand to the creation of Allah. You've read the hadith about how the believer doesn't beg, tries himself to stand on his own feet, financially become independent. That izzatun nafs that we need to gain. It goes back to the same concept. Yes, stand on your own two feet, become financially very strong, so you never extend your hand other than towards Allah. That builds an amazing sense of worth. You do not even extend your hand to other things, including, for example, who your parents are and who your families are. You've read this beautiful story. One of the companions says, by the name of Faqih, so I came the night near the Kaaba and I saw Imam al-Sajjad alayhi salam, he was worshipping Allah. He says, it was such a beautiful scene. They said, I started to cry. It's beautiful. It's very beautiful. In fact, I want to end with the story, so I'll just mention a point before I carry on the story. Something we need to try, something we need to really experience. Now that we've understood where true self-worth comes from, the nights of Qadr are upon us. One of the things that we need to do, and we should aim to do, is to go to our corner in the middle of the night on the nights of Qadr. Put your phone away, put the tablet away, take that watch out, right? Sit somewhere quiet, extend your hand, and tell Allah, I am nothing. This dua Abu Hamza Thumali needs to be read. Every word needs to be cherished. It's such a beautiful dua. It's a treasure in how we understand our relationship with Allah. So this person, he sits next to the Imam, admiring and enjoying the scene of the Imam worshipping Allah. And then when the Imam realizes that somebody is near me, he turns to him and says, who is here? So he says, I'm here, Ya Ibn Rasulullah. But I'm wondering, the likes of me should be worshipping like this. The sinners like me should be worshipping the way you worship. As for you, your grandfather is a prophet. Your father is Amirul Mu'mineen. Your mother is Fatimatu Zahra. The Imam turns to him and says, Da anni haditha abi wa jaddi wa ummi. Says, leave alone the talk of my grandfather and my father and my mother. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created paradise for the one who worships and obeys him. My worth doesn't come from who my grandfather is. To this extent, that your self-worth, forget your material possession, forget the praise from others, forget my career, not even the fact that my grandfather is the prophet and my mother is Fatima al-Zahra and my father is Amir al-Mu'mineen. Even that does not give me self-worth. What gives me self-worth is my connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how much I extend my hand only to Allah, realizing that I am nothing but a servant. To this extent. It's so beautiful. Isn't it so beautiful? Why is it beautiful? Because it goes back to reality. These emotions go back to reality. They're not fake, imaginary emotions. We want to make sure that our lives, our emotions and feelings always go back to reality, including self-esteem, including the idea that we have of ourselves. And so inshallah, to summarize, we realize how important it is to have a positive image of ourselves, how important it is to believe that we are worthy, to believe that we have value, that enables us to aim really high, to adopt really amazing traits of morality, to behave in such an amazing way, to stay away from sins and that which degrades our true worth. It's important to have this, but it's important to realize that this does not come from what we own. It does not come from the praise that we get from others. It does not come from the career that we have. Rather, it comes from faith. It comes from understanding that in the real world, in reality, in truth, everything belongs to Allah. فَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ جَمِيعًا. But if I am able to understand this, and I am able to realize that I am nothing, but at the same time, I am connected to absolute greatness, absolute power, absolute might, then that brings about a true sense of worth. And we do this, amongst the ways that we do this is through dua, through really extending our hands towards Allah only and telling Allah, oh Allah, my worth is nothing. My actions are worth nothing. I have nothing except one thing, hope. I come at your door knowing that you have told me never to reject a beggar. That the day a beggar comes to my door and says, I have nothing, you told me not to reject him. So I come to you in the same state, that I have nothing, I'm a beggar, you do not reject me. And I ask from you for everything. My cup is empty. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the tawfiq to understand the Quran, to understand the words of the Ahlul Bayt. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us a true faith and the tawfiq to perform good actions. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the tawfiq to be able to pray to Him and to make true dua, to benefit from the nights of Qadr and to receive the best of the best in the night of Qadr. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the hastening of the repentance of the 12th Holy Imam and that we are included amongst His loyal companions with the salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. Amen.